Hey, this is PCox. Welcome back to another Aether Revolt draft here on Channel Fireball. Just FYI, this is a competitive single elimination league, so if I lose a round, there won't be any more videos. So if you're wondering, you know, you lost round one, where's round two? Well, I didn't get to play round two. So, okay, we opened a Metallic Mimic, which is good, not great. I think it's a little better than people give it credit for. Like, people act like you have to draft like some kind of tribal deck for this to be good. I mean, it's just your 2-drop, and then your 3-drop is going to have a +1/+1 counter on it. Like, you can just name whatever's in your hand. And also, there's a lot of Artificers and Aetherborn just incidentally, so it's not too hard to get this to work. But we do have two really good uncommons. We have Hungry Flames and Monstrous Onslaught. I'm probably going to take Onslaught. I think it has the higher upside. The red is better than green, so I'm not actually sure. When I first drafted the format, it definitely would have been Onslaught. I guess I'll take it. It has not been as good as I would have hoped it to be. Of course, now we get a second Onslaught, so that's, you know, probably going to end up in green. But, you know, basically why this card is not as insane as it might look is there's not a lot of huge creatures in the format, so it's hard for you to have a thing that's going to deal enough damage to kill multiple things, though it can happen. And, you know, obviously if it just ends up being a 1-for-1 removal spell, it's not horrible fail state. So, still a pretty good card. I think it has to be the pick here. I mean, there's Scrounging Bandar would be the next pick out of the pack. Druid of the Cowl is fine, but as I just said, there's not a lot of big expensive creatures, so a little less good than it would be in other formats. I do think Dawnfeather Eagle is very great and, you know, possibly the best common, but given that I already picked an Onslaught, I'm just going to pick another one. All right, then no real green cards. I mean, High Spire Infusion, but that's not really very exciting. Don't really like Heart. Verdant Automaton is playable, but not very good. I don't love white-green, but I think this is probably the best card in this pack. Yeah, I guess I'm going to take this. We'll see. I hope I don't end up in white-green, but... Well, more ability to fight. This isn't exactly fighting, but, you know, basically. Could take Iron Tread Crusher. It is good with Onslaught. It's also good with Infiltrator. I don't really like this uncommon guy. It's pretty mediocre, you know. Like... Getting a 6/6 for 6 with, I mean, though you have to sacrifice something, like it's basically just like Cow Prowler with extra work. Like the life drain's probably not going to be worth enough that you're sacrificing something. So could take Countless Gears Renegade, or could take Prey Upon and kind of try and keep steering towards just green. I think that's what I want to do. But I could see an argument for like Crusher and maybe Renegade. I don't like Renegade all that much, but it's fine. Okay, well, this is an indicator that white is open. This doesn't necessarily indicate that red is open, but it indicates that red-green specifically is going to be open. So yeah, it's actually kind of a hard pick. Like, white and green don't really have like an identity necessarily in this format as far as I could tell. I mean, like Revolt a little bit, but it's mostly just kind of like, here's some good cards. You know, just if you draft those colors. I do like red-green, and this card is great, so I guess I'll speculate on this a little bit, though I might regret it when I don't have this Dawnfeather Eagle and don't see red either. Alright, so could go Sailback, mostly because it is actually good with Onslaught. Pretty mediocre card in general. Aether Herder, also mediocre, but does have the plus side of, like, we're definitely in green. So, I guess we'll Aether Herder. Yeah. Alright, not a lot exciting here. I mean, Obsolescence I will main deck, so that's fine. I'll take that. I guess High Spire Infusion? I mean, even if I end up in a different color, I'm not really excited by either of these black 3-drops, so... Sure. Uh, This is actually a little bit of a hard pick. I mean, I think it has to be Automaton, just because if I am going to be red-green, I don't have any 2-drop creatures yet. But given the two onslaughts, like, you do want random big creatures like this. I mean, we do have Boar already, but I think I need a draft for my curve, but, like, the sailback does go up. Alright, well. Given that I don't have any revolt cards yet, and red doesn't have revolts, so it's just basically Lifecraft Calvary. I think I just take Sailback here. Like, I'm not necessarily going to need the Renegade map, and, like, I do actually want big things for these onslaughts. So, not a pick I thought I would ever make, but, you know, drafting is contextual, and we have multiple cards. I mean, also the fight card, even more so than the onslaught, cares about having big creatures, just because they're dealing damage to your creature with that card, not just your creature being as big as possible in the power. Alright, so not a lot here. Even if I end up white, I'm probably not playing this. I guess I'll take Ice Over. Now, this is a league, so I know I'm not going to play against any of these cards, but I'm trying to draft how I would normally draft, and I would probably hate this, because if I'm playing a bunch of big creatures, then that is a reasonable answer to them. Well, Night Market Guard is not zero to make my deck. I think I like this card a little bit more than other people. Like, it's not great or anything, but you can improvise with it, and three powers matters for Crusher and stuff, and doesn't seem like I'm going to be white, so I guess I'm going to take this. I mean, that card going that late is somewhat of an indication that white may be open. Ooh, I almost took that earlier. People not respecting the Sailback, which is, again, a pretty mediocre card, but when you're trying to fight stuff, pretty good. Alright, so we got a big guy that we can actually improvise into, though we're not really short on big guys, and it's not that likely we're going to, like, do it any faster than turn 5. So, not totally insane. I mean, there is the option of, like, Siphoner, a pretty good card, and we're not 100% in red. Like, our red cards are a couple of the red cards are pretty mediocre, but they do fit in our deck. Or we take Lifecraft Calvary. Again, it's not, like, that much better than Sailback in our deck. I mean, it is a significantly better card, but, like, I think I'd rather have a removal spell. So I think we just take Revolution. Like, upgrading a medium 5-drop into a pretty good 5-drop is not worth more than just having a removal spell. So, I mean, I guess we do already have multiple onslaughts, so maybe it is worth a little more, but eh. Alright. Well, unless we end up finding map or something, this card is just okay. But I think it has to be the pick here. Like, we do want 2-drops. It's definitely better than Automaton. And, like, even if you're not going to, like, make it a 4-3 on turn 2 most of the time, just, like, in the mid-game, trading off and then playing, like, 2 spells in a turn and one of them is a 4-3 is pretty good. So I think this is the pick. I've actually been pleasantly surprised. I've never actually played this card, but I've played against it, and it's better than I thought it would be, but I just want 2-drops, so I think even if I had an even distribution of drops, this card is still going to be better just because the upside's pretty high. Well, we don't have any vehicles, so I don't think I want this. Aether Herder, again, pretty medium, but fine. Like, I think Prey Upon is better than it, but we are relatively low on creatures and high on pump spells, and you kind of want to have a lot of creatures to go with your pump spells, so I don't know. I mean, Aether Herder is pretty replaceable and crappy. Man. I think I'm going to take Prey Upon and possibly regret it. Like, I don't want to be removal flooded, but Aether Herder just doesn't really do much. Alright, so I probably just, I was going to say Welder Automaton, but if we don't really care about improvising, Racer's probably better. Like, this card is not totally insane or anything, but it is pretty good. Like, it's good, like, the ability is good with crewing, but the problem is the big common vehicle in this format crews for 3 instead of 2. two, like in the last format where we had Renegade Freighter, like this is kind of an all-star. I don't really like this vehicle that much. It's fine, but nothing to get excited about, hence not even really talking about it. I guess it's probably Eraser. Like, it is enough better than Automaton, especially if I don't care very much about artifacts at the moment. Well, Cogworker Assembler is okay. We don't really have a lot of artifacts in our deck. You can tutor for it, which is nice. You know, in the next set when you get the other Assembly Worker guys. Could take Verdant Automaton. Not too excited by that card. Or could take another Night Market Guard, but if we're not really crewing, I don't care that much about artifacts. This card is pretty mediocre. Yeah, nothing here is too exciting. I mean, this is kind of a mana sink, but we're going to have, like, Fatties in our deck, so that doesn't really matter. I guess I'll take Night Market Guard. Man, it's, none of that is really what I want to be taking right there. Yeah, Jesus. Guess I should have gone white. I mean, it's supposed to be white-red. This is, I wonder which of these cards... I think this card is, like, overall better. I wonder which of these is better against my deck. Probably Dawnfeather Eagle. Like, if I'm playing a bunch of big guys, I don't really care that much if they gain life. But this can, like, lead to fast kills. And again, I know this is not actually... I'm not actually playing against any of this, but I don't think I would play a frontline Revel, so I would take this. I try and draft as if I'm in a GP or whatever. Alright, well, I'll take the Aether Herder. Well, I was just saying this card's pretty decent, but I have so many fight cards that I just kind of want a big fatty. It's a weird pick, but I think it's right. Yeah, I mean, I think we want Crusher. We have a good amount of ways to crew it, because we kind of speculatively took these Night Market Guards. Could take Automaton, but that card's not very good. So, sure. Finality's not that good against me. I would probably take this as a sideboard card, but I'd have to be playing against a really aggressive deck to feel like I needed this. Hard to imagine a scenario where I'd want to be wrangling, so just take something for someone else's curve. Probably not playing the second infusion, because I have too many spells already, I think, and the other ones are going to be better than pump spells. Well, open a Torrential Gear Hulk, which is worth like $15, I think, which pays for my draft. Which is not really how I'm supposed to be drafting in terms of if I'm playing in a tournament, though. I've had mixed results not taking these cards in the drafts as far as people commenting like, oh, you should definitely have taken that, what are you, stupid? And yeah, I guess I don't know. I kind of just want to take Thriving Grubs. I suppose I'll take $15. You guys can let me know if that's not preferable. I don't really care that much, to be honest. If people think I should not take that while recording, that's fine. So anyway, Wildest Dreams, a card I think I like more than most people. People back to like this card's unplayable. If you have like a bunch of cheap spells, it's actually pretty good. Like just as the top end in your deck. Now my deck already has enough top end. Like I might not want it exactly here. But, you know, if you have, like, Prey Upons, like, Shocks, Harness Lightnings, that kind of thing, then it is actually pretty nice. Like, because, like, if you're not facing down any pressure and you just get, like, three cards back with this, it's pretty insane. But if you just get one or two cards back and just, like, can immediately cast one of them, that's also just very powerful. So, anyway, got another consideration that we could potentially splash. Not that we have any ability to splash yet. Weldfast Monitor. I think we just want Thriving Grubs. We're pretty low on two drops. Like, all these two drops are spells, so And Thriving Grubs is a pretty good 2-drop. Alright. This is a pretty good pack. Alright. Fairgrounds Trumpeter. Do we have any plus one counter type stuff? I don't actually think so. Just the one. So that's out. Doorbuster, I think, is probably a little better than Outrider in a vacuum. We're not super aggressive, and our guy's going to be pretty big, so it doesn't matter that much. And I feel like a good tiebreaker is that two of our removal spells are prey upons, and a 4-4 is much better with a prey upon than a 4-2. So I think we'll take this. Well, we don't care about energy at all, so this is just a 2-1, which is pretty bad. Or we can just take a Wayward Giant, which is basically an upgrade to Sailback, but a very marginal one. They're pretty close to the same card. I mean, one pretty reasonable difference is this doesn't die to Chandra's Revolution. Yeah, I don't know. It's like a 2-1 for 2 with no other ability essentially in our deck is pretty bad. I guess it works with this, with Aether Herder. I mean, I think there's some chance this makes our deck, even though I hope it doesn't, so it's probably better to take this than another 5-drop red marginal thing. Alright, well, this is weird. This has the wrong art. There we go. Alright. Yeah, I mean, 2-1 haste, occasionally give our Crusher haste, is definitely better than 2-1 no ability. Could also take Eager Construct here, but I think we want this, assuming we end up playing the Crusher, which we probably will. Probably not in Andara Express territory, though Sandblack does like this as like a sideboard card. Basically in this sort of deck where you can like pretty reasonably crew it with only one creature. Now, this Kalprowler might replace one of these Sailbacks. Not that it's a great card, but it's fine. It's very big. Don't think I need to demolish, so taking it regardless. Alright, now this is interesting. Cobra is pretty good. We were a little light on 2-drops. We're not nearly as light anymore, so you know, turning our Sailback or whatever into a Ballista Charger is actually pretty nice. Like, Ballista Charger is quite good. Also, you know, we do have a couple guys. Well, neither of them, like, actually easily crew, like, the crew threes. Like, you can tap two things, and they have abilities when you crew. So that is not irrelevant. Yeah, I don't know. I think I have, like, a decent number of top ends. I actually have a decent number of 2-drops now, too, but I'll take this. Yeah, it's like, do I want artifact removal, or do I want, like, some defense against flyers? It's probably defense against flyers. Like, I do have a decent number of removal spells, but, you know, even if I don't main deck this, if I play against a blue-white skies deck, I'm going to be happy to have access to this. I guess I could side this in. It seems incredibly unlikely. I think it's probably just like this would probably be the most annoying card to play against. Just marginally or incrementally tap my guy, or incidentally. Find the right word eventually. Yeah, none of this is likely to matter against me. Oh, got the Wayward Giant back. How lucky. High deck would probably be good against this deck. I have a bunch of giant creatures. Alright, so let's go ahead and start cutting cards. Probably don't need this Artisan, at least in the main deck. Definitely don't want this Sage. I should probably group creatures separately here. Um, I do not think we want all of these pump spells. We might want some small number of them. Probably do not want all these 5 drops. Also not necessarily... We don't necessarily want the Iron Tread Crusher. Like, our cheap guys don't crew it that easily. You know, we have 1, 2, 3 of our small creatures that crew it. You know, if we were white and we had, you know, a bunch of this guy... Basically, it's easier to crew in, like, a, you know, a white-red deck or whatever. It does have a pretty high plus side with having a 6-power guy with Monstrous Onslaught, though we can pretty easily just play other big creatures and not have to kind of work to have our big creature, so that might just be better. I mean, we're cutting at least one sail back, I think. Like, we don't want our curve to be insanely high. And it's also possible we don't want Cal Prowler, though... I think it's fine to have, like, 1 6-drop, like, instead of just having, like, 4 5-drops that are all smaller and less exciting. Alright, so... You know, despite us being pretty concentrated on getting 2 drops, we did end up with enough, so... You know, we could potentially cut, like, a Speedway Fanatic. We're not super aggressive. It doesn't matter that much if we give Iron Tread Crusher haste. We could also cut an Infusion, or we could play, like, Ornamental Courage instead. Yeah, I'm not really sure what the last cut should be. Could be an Aether Herder. Like, our curve is a little bit high. Fanatic's probably not going to do a lot. Yeah, no, given how expensive everything is, it feels like if I want a pump spell that maybe it should just be Ornamental Courage. Like, it can just... It's going to be more easily to double spell using that than High Spire Infusion. Of course, I could play no pump spells and just play Speedway Fanatic. I don't think I have other options, right? Don't want to splash this Torrential Gearhulk. Also don't, like, have to main deck Natural Obsolescence, though. It has enough targets that it's probably correct, too. Interestingly, even though I was like, oh yeah, you know, the 1-3 mana guy is not that great in this format, like, it still has his decks. Like, I would have been very happy if, like, all of my 2-drops were that card in this deck, where I'm just kind of trying to play some fatties. I mean, my curve would definitely be nicer with another 2-drop, or ideally another 3-drop, but just Speedway Fanatic is just pretty low impact. So I don't think I want to do that. I do wish I had, like, a Wild Wanderer, I think it's called, like the 3-2 that searches for a land or something that gives me incidental extra mana, because I don't really want to play 18 lands, but, you know, 17 does... I want to play, like, 17 and a half lands, basically. Yeah, I think this looks good. That seems too biased. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 red cards. I mean, maybe 10, 7? I mean, I still have red 2-drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 green cards. Yeah, it's probably 10, 7, despite having a red 2-drop. Because, like, I have 4 double green cards. I also, like, am going to want to, like, prey upon and play another green spell a decent amount of the time, probably. Sure. Yeah, and just going back for a second, I think the one thing I am kind of unsure of is if I actually want to play this Iron Tread Crusher. Like, I do like that it lets me keep attacking, like with some of my smaller creatures when they're otherwise gonna be blanked at that point in the game. But having like five of my seven small creatures not crew it is pretty annoying. I mean, I guess it makes my Aether Herder a little better. And I do think I want to play the Aether Herders because I have this, so it's better to have a three power guy than a Reckless Racer or whatever. But could play like another five drop instead of Crusher. I guess that like lessens my ability to like curve into Onslaught. Like if I go Night Market Guard into this and Onslaught, or just two drop, three drop into this and Onslaught, that is pretty backbreaking. Yeah, I think the high end of being able to Onslaught for six on turn four probably means I should just play this.